explaining about the architecture of SIC bar XC machine. So first we discuss about the memory. Memory in SIC also we have memory 8 bit forms bytes, 3 bytes we call it as a word. These words are addressed by the location of the lowest numbered of bytes. And the maximum memory available in SIC bar XC is 2^20 bytes. But in SIC it is 2^15 bytes. Okay, about registers. In SIC bar XC, there is a total of 9 registers is available. A, accumulator register for arithmetic operation. X register, index register, which is used for indexed addressing mode. Linkage register. Linkage register is used by subroutine instruction to store the return address during the subroutine linkage. And program counter, which is another register which is used to hold the address of the next executable instruction. The status word, that is used for storing the condition code information or the status of the CPU. In addition to this, we have 4 registers. B register, base register, which is used for base relative addressing. S and T are general purpose registers. Okay, F is a floating point accumulator register. These B, S, T, F registers are not available in SIC, but in SIC bar XC these are available. Total 9 registers are available in SIC bar XC. About the data format, it has integers. Integers is represented by using 24 bit binary numbers. Negative numbers are represented by using 2's complement. Characters are represented by using 8 bit ASCII codes. There is a floating point representation in SIC bar XC, but in SIC it is not available. In SIC bar XC, floating point numbers are there. It is represented by using 48 bit sign bit 1, exponent 11 bit, and 36 bit for fractional part of this floating point number. Fraction is actually a value between 0 and 1. Exponent has the value between 0 and 2047. So a number, floating point number in SIC bar XC is represented by a fraction into 2^-1024. That is the normalized representation of this floating point number. So about the instruction format, there are mainly 4 instruction format is available in SIC bar XC. Each instruction format has different length. 8 bit, first instruction format has 8. Another one is 16 bit, another has 24, and another has length 32 bit length. So 8 bit instruction format which has only opcode only. Example, return sub instruction. Okay, this is the opcode only. There is 16 bit instruction, that is opcode register 1 register 2. That type of instruction format is available in SIC bar XC. Opcode 8 bit, register 1 4 bit and register 2 4 bit. There is opcode format 3 instruction, actually its length is 24 bit. That is opcode 6 bit NIXBPE bits. So these, each bit has 1 bit capacity, each flag has. Then there is a 12 bit displacement field is there. And in format 4, 6 bit for opcode, NIXBPE bits, each of 1 bit size, and 20 bit address is there. So the addressing modes used in format 3. In the format 3, so E bit is actually for differentiating for format 3 and format 4. E bit is 0 means format 3 instruction. E bit is 1 means it is format 4 instruction. So E bit is for differentiating about format 3 and format 4. And in format 3, B and P bits are there. B bit is for, if B is 1 and P is 0 means base relative addressing mode is there. If B is 0 and P is 1 means program counter relative addressing mode is there. So the target address in the case of base relative addressing mode is content of base register plus displacement field in format 3. If it is program counter relative addressing mode, then the target address of the operand is the content of program counter plus displacement field. Okay, if B and P bit both 0, then the DISP field is taken as the target address. In format 4, in the case of format 4, B and P are usually set to 0. So the target address is the address given in the instruction itself. So we call it as a direct addressing mode. In the case of format 4 instruction, B and P both are set 0. So the address given in the instruction is the target address of the operand. Moreover, in the case of format 3 and format 4, there is I and N bits. If I is equal to 1 and N is equal to 0 means immediate addressing mode is there. That is, the operand itself is given in the instruction itself. I is equal to 0 and N is equal to 1 means indirect addressing mode. Indirect addressing mode is that first we check the address given in the instruction, then we will go to that address that will contain the address of the operand. I and N is equal to 0 or 1 means symbol addressing mode. That is, the address given in the instruction, we go to that memory location which will contain the operand. Okay. So, this is the regarding the addressing modes. Then about instruction set. LDA, regarding to memory related instruction, LDA, STA, load base register, store base register, LDT, STT, all it's available in SIC bar XE. So, floating point operations, there are add f, mull f, div f, okay, sub f, and for register to register operations, add r, sub r, mull r, div r is available in addition to add sub mull instructions. In addition to this, register move RMO instruction and SVC, supervisor call instruction, which is for interrupt processing or to get the attention of the operating system service routine, we use SVC instructions. Regarding the input-output operation, in addition to TD, RD and WD, there are input-output channels is available in SIC bar XE. Okay, input-output channels are available. So, to start input-output channel SIO, to test input-output channel TIO, halt input-output channel HIO. So, these three additional instructions, in addition to TD, RD and WD, we have SIO, HIO and TIO instructions are available in SIC bar XE. These are input-output channels that can be used to perform input-output operation while the CPU is executing other instructions. So, these are the just architecture of SIC bar XE. Okay, thank you.